Louis Vuitton Neverfull versus Goyard St. Louis. Which one is a better buy? Which one holds up over time? And which one do I recommend? Always something in the air. I've been talking about my Louis Vuitton Neverfull for years. You guys know how practical of a bag this is, but every single time I share my Goyard St. Louis, I get asked to compare these two bags. Which one is a better buy? Which one do I recommend? So that's what we're gonna dive in today. I wanna talk about a few different topics. First and foremost, let's talk about price. The Louis Vuitton Neverfull retails for $1,690 in the MM size. It does come in three different sizes, one size larger and one size smaller, and there is a $100 difference. Like I said, this is the MM size, which is the medium size. It also comes with a pouch. This is the exact pouch that comes with both the MM size and the GM size. The PM pouch is a little bit smaller. The Goyard St. Louis comes in two different sizes. This is the PM size. It also comes in a GM size. And yes, they also come with a pouch as well. The PM size retails for $1,200 for the classic colors and $1,560 for the special colors. And then of course the GM size is a few hundred dollars more than this one. Let's go ahead and chat really quickly about the two pouches that do come with the bags. Now keep in mind, this is the size that comes with the Goyard PM. I can't remember if the GM size is larger, and this is the size that comes with the Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the MM size, as well as the GM size, and the PM size is definitely smaller. I will say, I don't think that this pouch gets enough love, and this is definitely an incentive to buy the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. I actually use this pouch all of the time. It may look super flat, but I've shared how much can fit inside here. I can fit my phone, my keys, a lip gloss, and kind of like just my main essentials, like a card holder with my, you know, an ID and a credit card, maybe even a little bit of cash in here. And then I carry it as a wristlet. It is perfect to take to the gym or just run to the grocery store. I do not use this one, I will be honest. I just don't think it's as practical. However, they both do come with it. They both are removable. However, I do want to point out one thing in regards to the Goyard. So even though the Goyard pouch is removable, you can see here is the strap that is left on the tote. You cannot completely remove this strap from the bag. It is sewn on here. You could cut it off if you wanted to. I'm just not sure if you would want to do that. But either way, this strap cannot be removed, even though the pouch itself can. Next up, I just want to talk about weight really quickly. I do get a few questions about the weight of both of these bags. I will say I have always considered the Neverfull tote a very, very lightweight bag. It really is. It is super, super lightweight, especially if I compare it to my other handbags. However, when it comes to weight, the Goyard wins by far. This tote is so, so lightweight. And if you've never seen one in person, you actually might be kind of turned off by the thickness of the canvas because it is so, so thin. Like, it is so thin. I'm gonna do this to my bag just for the sake of sharing it with you. But look at how thin this bag is. It is like crinkle paper with a very, very light coating versus the Neverfull. This canvas feels really nice and substantial and thick and a very, very high quality. Whereas the canvas of this one is super thin, making this definitely the winner in the weight category. This one is much more lightweight for sure. Now that we've talked about weight, I think this is a really good transition to talk about the wear and tear of both of these bags. I think that if you've truly felt both of these bags, I think it's pretty safe to say that the wear and tear on the Neverfull is so much better over time versus the wear and tear of the Goyard St. Louis. I have definitely had just as many issues with the glazing for my Goyard totes as I have for any of my Louis Vuitton pieces. It is no secret that Louis Vuitton has issues with the glazing. I will say I have never had to have this particular Neverfull or really any of my Neverfulls reglazed. However, I do know that that is a known issue and people just are more aware of the glazing on Louis Vuitton pieces. However, I will say The same issue exists with this particular bag from Goyard. I cannot speak to other pieces from Goyard. This is the only item that I have from Goyard. Keep in mind, I did own the GM size prior to owning the PM size. I actually owned the GM size for probably about 2 years, and I just realized I never reached for it. And one of the reasons why I never reached for that particular size or that particular bag was because of the size. It just was so floppy to me, and I decided to go ahead and order the PM size in the same color combo while I still owned the GM size, just to really determine which one I preferred. And I much preferred the PM size. I ended up selling the GM size, and I will say I reached for the PM size a lot more than I did my GM size. I definitely feel like comparing the Goyard PM to the Neverfull MM is great as far as what fits inside, but as far as like the look and vibe of them, I do feel like this one is actually more comparable to the GM size, because this gives a very slouchy look to it versus a little bit more of a structured look to this one. What that basically means is when you have the Goyard St. Louis in such a thin canvas, but you also have that slouchiness, you are gonna deal with more wear and tear in the corners. You are gonna deal with, you know, some glazing issues on the handles here. I actually had issues with my GM, and I reached out to Goyard and asked how they handled it, what the process was, because I actually started having cracking on my handles for that particular bag within a month or two of owning it. And they unfortunately offered no resolution. They said that I could pay to have the glazing redone, which was gonna be a few hundred dollars. And I just felt that that was a very disappointing response from customer service for a bag that I had owned about a month and a half and maybe worn it 2 or 3 times. When I compare my experience to Louis Vuitton for a similar issue, it is nothing like that. Now, again, I've never had any issues with the glazing with this particular bag at all, but I have had glazing issues with Louis Vuitton in general, and every single time I've ever had a glazing issue with Louis Vuitton, they offered to reglaze it completely free, or in some cases have even replaced my bag entirely. So overall, I would say not only is the wear and tear gonna be better for the Neverfull bag versus the Goyard bag, but the customer service and the aftercare of the bag is so much better when it comes to Louis Vuitton versus Goyard. I was really, really disappointed with the fact that I had owned the bag for just a little over a month and they offered no resolution. It really kind of turned me off to the brand in general. And I don't know, I'm not saying I won't ever buy another Goyard bag, but I will say I definitely keep that in mind if I were ever to consider it again. Putting my Goyard issue aside, I still get asked which house is a better brand to buy into. And I will say, you cannot go wrong with either brand. Both have been around for a very, very long time. They actually both started very, very similarly. You should look up their stories. It's quite interesting. They both started with luggage and just took a different path when it comes to marketing. Goyard is very exclusive. There's not very many boutiques around the United States. I actually had to order this over the phone. I had to fill out paperwork and they shipped it to me. So I actually purchased this sight unseen, versus Louis Vuitton is a little bit more mainstream. Even though it is luxury, and even though these two bags are very comparable in price, it is more readily available and it is a little bit more of a household luxury brand name. But I still think that both brands are great brands to buy into. Even though I had the issue with Goyard, I can't imagine that the brand would be as popular as it is today if they had those issues on a regular basis. So I wanted to go ahead and dive into the look of the two bags, and I wanted to show the Neverfull MM as well as the GM, just because I think when you're looking at the Neverfull, you're most likely trying to decide between these two different sizes. Now, keep in mind, I do have a video comparing these two sizes if you want a little more detail in regards to that. But I do want to just talk about the general look of the MM size versus the GM size, and then compare the look to the Goyard tote as well. So when I look at the Neverfull in the MM size, I feel like this is a tote. It is a little bit more structured. It looks like a tote. It's not gonna change the shape. It just is a tote. And hopefully that makes sense, or it'll make more sense, especially once I share the GM size and the Goyard tote as well. But even once I fill this up, it is gonna keep this general structure. It's not gonna look a lot different. Yes, you can bring the sides in. I personally don't like that look when you're talking about this particular size, but for the most part, it is gonna look exactly like this, whether it is full or it is empty. This is what it looks like. It is just a big hole with your things inside that you grab and you pull out, and it looks like a tote. So here is the Neverfull in the GM size. I did put a few things in there just because I wanted to show you what it starts to look like once you start to fill it up. Because you have this really, really large surface area on the bottom, if you don't have any sort of bag shaper or anything in there, which I actually prefer the slouch of the GM size, then it is gonna create this very relaxed, casual look, which I love. Yes, I love the MM size. I think it's a very, very practical tote. However, if you're looking for a tote with kind of a vibe, I really think the GM is the way to go. I love the slouchiness that this gives, and the more you put in it, the slouchier it is. And then even when you put it on, I just feel like it's kind of floppy. It's like the oversized sweater version of a handbag. I also do happen to love the way this one looks with the sides in. You can get a really, really different look, and it still kind of has that sagginess to it. So I do like the way this one looks. I love the versatility of the GM size for sure. And here is the St. Louis in the PM size. I feel like it's Louis Vuitton Neverfull MM and the GM had a baby, but it just is a little bit thinner as far as the canvas. But you've got the size of the MM with the slouch of the GM, but in the Goyard tote. But this is exactly why I had an issue with this exact tote in the GM size. It literally became flat whenever I carried this bag with things in it. It would literally just become a huge like line. I would be carrying this and it would be sagging all the way down to my thigh. I just didn't like the way that it looked. It was almost too much of a sag, whereas I feel like the PM gives the perfect amount of sag. Your things are in there, there's a little bit of shape, there's a little bit of like that casual effortless vibe, but it's not so big that things just fall to this little hole in the bottom and things don't get lost. I can open it, I can still see my items, but you've got this like effortless vibe that I love so much in the Neverfull GM with the size that I love of the Neverfull MM. So what is my final verdict? Which one do I think you should buy and which one is the better investment? I am definitely gonna go with the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. I feel like the quality of the Neverfull compared to this particular bag from Goyard is so much better. I also will say the customer service of Louis Vuitton is a whole lot better in regards to really anything, period. But I also reached for the Louis Vuitton Neverfull more because I know that this is a much thinner canvas. I do worry about it over time. Do I necessarily regret having the Goyard St. Louis in my collection? No, but I also consider myself a luxury handbag collector. So I love having the option, but I will say I know that I need to be a lot more careful with this tote than I do with my Neverfulls. I really, really consider my Neverfulls the kind of bag that I can wear every single day, and I know that it is just gonna work its butt off. They are just such amazing bags. They have held up so, so well. I've had this one for many, many years. So definitely the Neverfull wins for sure. Whether you get the MM size or the GM size, you really cannot go wrong. Make sure to watch that video where I compare the two different sizes if you're still not sure which size to get. But when it comes to Louis Vuitton versus Goyard, Louis Vuitton wins. So that is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you have any other bags that you would like for me to compare, make sure to put those down in the comments below. If you're new to my channel, my name is Amanda. It is so nice to meet you. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and that notification button, and I will see you guys in the next one. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.